this lesson, we will learn how to install Git and create a new repository, work within our project, a Java project, and try to use some Git, very basic Git command. Git is a version control system. This means that with Git you can conserve the history, all the history of your project. Furthermore, Git allows you to work in a better way with other co-authors of your project, since you can see who modified the code. To install Git, there are some. In this slide is the procedure to install Git on Linux, on Mac, and on Windows. You just go to git scm.com download win, and you can download Git. When you have installed Git, the first thing is to set your username and email address. To do this, just open git command line and digit this command git config global user.name with your name, and then you can set your user email. Once you have to check if everything was done correctly, just run the command git config list, and you can see the username and email on your git command line. When we work with Git, we can just work with within our machine, with the local, the so-called local repository. But the best thing is to use Git with GitHub, that is a web-based service that uses Git to version as a version control system. So we can create our GitHub account. Just going to github.com. And here we can sign up with a new account. And when we have created our GitHub account, we have our remote repository to which we can push everything we have committed on our local repository. So in this way, it is possible to have always an updated version of our work that we can pull from to our machine or to another machine, and this allows you to collaborate with other users. So in this slide, we can better clarify what is Git, what is GitHub. on the left there is Git with where we have our working directory on our machine, and everything is added to a staging area and then committed. That means it is permanently recorded to our local repository. If we want, we can use GitHub to store everything as a copy of our local repository to our remote repository. And to do this, we can use the command git push. And when from a remote repository we can get the project, we just run the command git. So to start, we can we have the Hello World project in Eclipse. We can use it as a test. So we can initialize this project folder with the git. So in git command line, we set in the folder project with the command cd. Now I'm in the folder of my project Hello World, and to initiate Hello World as a Git repository, just run the command git init. So with this command, we just added this folder .git inside our folder project, and this folder will contain everything of our history. So if you delete this one and you don't have a copy on GitHub, you have lost all the history of your project. The next step is to create a new repository on GitHub. So we can go to GitHub webpage. We can create a new repository and we call it Hello World. We can just add a description of this repository. And we can add also a general public license to the repository. So this is my Hello World repository. Now I have just to connect my local repository with this remote repository. So in git command line, I run the following command, git remote add origin, and then I copy the HTTPS of my repository. So the command is git remote add origin. And then in the web page of your repository, you can clone and just copy the HTTPS of the repository. Then the first thing to do is to update the local repository with the remote one. Since when we created the repository, we have added the license file. So in Git, just in Git command line, just run the following command: git pull origin master. A brief comment on this: so git pull origins means that the local repository pull from the remote one that we call origin, and in particular the master means the branch that I want to pull. When you create a remote repository, you are in the master branch by default. So if I go to my work folder, I see that now there is a new file that is licensed, that has been pulled from the remote repository. The command git status
si libera di un'altra cosa, ma non sono visto da qualche quello c'è, non è molto grande, è un quarto terzo, quindi non è di quelli due.
Però sì, dopo passo.
Se mai ce l'ho di là, te lo faccio vedere.
D'accordo,
un bel monitor, bello, carino, come estetica, però non so le tue funzionalità, c'è la carta di resto di guai, quindi si può collegare col cavo bianco per vederci.
Perfetto.
Dacci una piatta, te lo lascio lì.
D'accordo, grazie.
Prego.
To know the status of our local repository, just run the command git status. So the output is that we are in the branch master, and there are some so-called untracked file, that is the .classpath, .project, the folder bin, and the folder src. So now, with the command git add, I can add this file to the staging area. And now I can check again the status of the repository. And I see that new files are added to the staging area, and these files are the class path, the project one, the folder bin, and the src folder. So these files now are ready to be committed to the local repository. That means that they will be added to the revision history of the repository. So the command is git commit minus m, and then I write a descriptive message that I suggest you to be as clear as possible, since when you want to go back to retrieve some older commit, this message will tell you what you have done. How do you modify the files? So in this case, the message could be first comment. Now I can, for example, with the command git log, I can see the commit history of my repository. So the first one was when I pulled from my remote repository, and the second one is the first commit that I have just done. Sometimes, for example, now I just modify one line to my project. And I would like that this last modification is merged, put within the first commit. So instead of doing another commit, a second one, I can just run this commit, this command, git commit minus minus amend. So what I have done is just simply take the last modification and I have put it inside the previous commit. The option no edit means that I don't want to modify the descriptive message of the previous commit, but if I want, it is possible to. If you want, it is possible to modify this. The previous commit message, just simply with the command git commit minus minus amend minus m, and here I can modify the text. First commit added new. So running git log to see the list of the commits, I see that now the last commit that before was simply first commit is now first commit added a new line to print channel. These last two commands are useful if you want to simply add a file to the previous commit, or if you want to modify the descriptive message of the last commit you have done. Sometimes maybe it happens that you perform some modification to your code, you add to the staging area, and then you realize that you don't want that. You realize that you have done an error, or you simply don't want to add this last modification to your version history. So to cancel a file from the staging area, you have just to run the command git reset head and the file name. So for example, in my project, I add these lines. I go to Git command line, I check the status of my repository. I see that the hello world class has been modified, so I add it to the staging area. But now I realize that what I have written in this code is wrong. So I would like to clean the staging area. I would like to remove the hello world class from the staging area. I just run the command git reset head and the file name. So now the status with the command git status, I see that I have still an untracked file on my local repository. This file is the hello world class. It is possible to not only to see the, before we have seen the command git log that allows you to watch the history, the commit history of your local repository. It is possible also to just to watch the commit history of a specific file, and to do this just run the command git log minus minus follow and the file name. In this case I just want to see to watch the history of the hello world.java file, and I see that I have just one commit. Now we go on with our code. So I just add some other lines. Git command line, I check the status of my repository. Again, my hello world file has been modified, so I add that to the staging area. And I commit it. I modify again and I add this line. I add again and commit. Now I decide that the last two commits are not interesting for my work, so I would like to go back to the first one, to the first commit. So it allows me to do this simply by doing this. So I checked the commit history for the Hello World Java file. Hit log, follow. So I would like to go back to the first commit. I see, as you can see, each commit is identified by a number, a hexadecimal number. So what I do, I can use this code to retrieve the first commit. And the command is git checkout. And I copy the alphanumeric code of the first comment. And as you can see, in the Hello World file, I have the first version of the code. The last line I have added there aren't in the code. So I go back to the first version of the code. And this is very useful when you develop your code, since sometimes you go ahead with the work and then you realize that there is some bug or something wrong that you don't want. You need to go back. When you work with the Git, it can be useful to use the Git ignore file. This is a special file that is added into the folder project. And this file contains all those files that shouldn't be tracked by Git. To create this file, just create a new txt file called git ignore. For example, here you can enter the file name you don't want that git look at. So for example, class path, project, and the folder, the bin folder. From Windows command line, you can rename this file just to change the extension. So you set in the project folder, in the folder project. And then run this command, ren. Stands for rename, git ignore.txt, rename as dot git. This is my, and you can see I renamed the file and changed its extension. Now in git, I can see that I have added a new file, git status. I can add to the staging area. And commit. So now we can see, we can look at a branch. Branch is we are now in the position one, we are in the master, and now we would like to open a new branch to develop, to cope with a specific task of our work. So all the modification will be done on this branch. The master remains clean, and when we are satisfied of our work, we can merge the branch with the master again. So this is a strategy to maintain the main line of the development always clean and work. And everything that has to be developed is developed on lateral, let's say, lines that are called branch. To create a new branch, we just run the command git checkout minus v and the branch name, in this case first underscore branch. As you can see, now git switched to a new branch that is the first branch. With the command git branch, it is possible to look at the branches that are present in our local repository. As you can see, there is the master and the first branch, and we are in the first branch. So I modify, perform some modification to the code. On git I check for modification with the git status. I add to the staging area. So now the branch is clean, and if I switch to the master branch, git checkout master, I see that in the code, I have the code that I've written before. Now I would like to add to this master the modification that I have done in the branch. I want to merge these two lines. So since I want to merge the branch to the master, I have to be in the master as I am and run the command git merge first branch. Here git say tell me that the automatic merge failed, so I have to fix manually the conflict. So if I go to the hello world class, I see that this part between from line 7 to line 14 is what there was before, the head. And from line 14 to 17 is what is added from the first branch. So for me this merge is okay, so I just cancel this line. This is what I have written in the master branch, This is the line that comes from the first branch. I save the file, and I go back to Git, Git status. And as you can see, there is the hello world.java. Before I have done a small error, since here in the Git status I see that there is a new file that is the gitignore. Because I have added the gitignore, I added the gitignore to the first branch and not in the master. So my master is now is clean. I can now decide to push everything to the remote repository. So I have a copy of my project on GitHub. So I run the command git push origin, that is the word that tells to git which is the remote repository, and I want to push this to the master of my repository. Now, here I can see all the files that I have created. In the source code there is a hello world, and this is the code. I can watch the history. So, for example, in the second commit, these green lines are the lines that I have added. This is the what I have done in the first branch. If now I delete some lines, for example this one, and I push it to the remote repository. Save the file. check for the history. And the last commit tells me that I have deleted these lines that I wrote. If you want, it is possible instead to start a completely new branch. It is possible to go back to a specific commit and start a branch from that point. To do this, you can just run the command git checkout minus b, the branch name, and then you specify with the alphanumeric code of the commit from which you want to start the branch. So for example, I want to start a new branch, for example, from the first commit. So I git log the first commit is this one. So I copy the alphanumeric code. Copy the alphanumeric code. So here the code is that was the first commit with just the yellow print output. And here I can start to work and then eventually merge with the master. Remember that you are not required to merge a branch to the master. That means if you want, you can continue to work on a branch like this one without merging with the master, with other branch. Another important thing to remember is that when you are on a branch, you can create another branch. For example, from 5 you can create another branch here, and then you can merge with the lines and then go on. So you can have a different level of branching.